So you ask ChatGPT a question and the answer is not right. Maybe the AI chatbot gave you a bunch of unverified or even made up results, or maybe it just doesn't make any sense. Here are some tips on how to talk to ChatGPT or any AI. While you can't control the AI itself, you can control how you prompt it. To start off, you want to be brief and clear. So the vaguer your prompt is, the vaguer the answer you'll get. So you want to make sure you provide all the necessary contextual information, but keep a narrow focus. For example, instead of asking what is climate change, which gives you a thorough but pretty vague answer, you might want to ask something else, like what do scientists say are the driving factors of climate change? Now, this answer is definitely more specific, but it's still too long and there are way too many emojis for me. I would rather get this information from a scientist, which leads us to another rule. Give it a roll. AI chatbots generate responses based on the prompts you give them. ChatGPT has access not only to information, but to different voices and personalities too. So the chatbot itself doesn't really have one stable identity or role. Think of it like this. You're speaking to a shapeshifter and you want to ask it to impersonate anyone you want. So this time, let's say you are a scientist. Explain the driving factors of climate change and do not use emojis. So this looks a lot better. There's not a single leaf emoji and I'm getting all the information I need. But the problem is I don't know where any of this information is coming from. I don't trust AI immediately and you shouldn't either. So the next step is to not forget to ask for sources. The thing about ChatGPT's role-playing is that it doesn't always differentiate between fact and fiction. So sometimes it can give you results for things that it made up. This is known as hallucinating. So ask for sources or specify that you are looking for evidence-based answers. And ask it to specifically note if any of the sources are uncertain. So this time we'll search, you are a scientist. Explain the driving factors of climate change. And do not use emojis. Give me all of your sources. So now we're getting linked out to science reports. We're being told exactly where all of this information is coming from. We're getting specific answers to our specific questions, and we don't have to rely on ChatGPT's knowledge. And finally, here's a helpful tip. You might have noticed I haven't been saying please and thank you. And you also may have seen the memes about being nice to your AI in order to be spared when it finally takes over the world. But jokes aside, it doesn't really matter if you're nice or not to ChatGPT. Being polite to whoever the chatbot impersonates will generate polite results, just like in human communication. But if you're rude to it, it may respond in kind. But saying words like please and thank you doesn't alter the technical output of the machine. Using unnecessary words can have a negative impact, as each word you generate requires extra computing time, which increases energy consumption, as the maintenance of large data models requires huge amounts of energy and water resources. In a recent investigation, Bloomberg discovered that around 2/3 of data centers built in the US since 2020 are in places with high levels of water stress. Each prompt you send to ChatGPT amounts to bite-sized tokens, and adding unnecessary phrases like please and thank you increases the computing power needed for your prompt. In April 2024, ChatGPT had 1.8 billion users, and a study in the same year indicated that 67% of US users are polite to their chatbot. And though it's difficult to estimate exactly how much computing power etiquette has cost, that's a lot of unnecessary please and thank yous that really serve no practical purpose. How do you talk to ChatGPT? Let us know your strategies in the comments, and if you want more how-to videos like this one, subscribe to our channel.